In this video, I'm gonna test which one is better, the new feature in Photoshop Super Resolution or Topaz Gigapixel AI. Coming up. Hi there, I'm Peter Forska, a professional photographer from Helsinki, Finland. And let's get right into the business. Photoshop just released a new feature in their Camera Raw software, which is part of Photoshop, of course. A feature called Super Resolution, which can double the size of your image, or the pixel amount on each side will be doubled. So actually the image will be four times bigger. And I had a video about the Super Resolution and compared it to the high-res files in Olympus EM1 Mark II, and found out certain things, and you can watch it from there. By the way, sun is shining. It's really bright outdoors. I hope I can get this in one shot so that the background doesn't change light doesn't change that much in the background. I just like to keep it open. It looks better, in my opinion, than if I close in the drapes. But enough for that chit-chat about the sun is shining. I had made an image for that super resolution video, and you probably, those who have seen it, it is a cityscape from Tervasaari Island, which is right next to downtown Helsinki. And I will use the same image here because that will give me some more information when I have. But I will also see how these two softwares work on a portrait, which is a 16 megapixel image taken with EM1 Mark II with the 45mm f1.8. Lens. And as we can see from these two images, these are the images from the same spot that I used in the super resolution video. And as you can see, the Gigapixel AI looks a bit better, and actually quite a lot better. And the reason is that there are a lot more things that you can adjust in Gigapixel AI. Photoshop, it just press enhance and choose super resolution, and it takes a few seconds and then it's done. It's really fast and an efficient way of doing, of course. But with Gigapixel, you have these options here. And on this particular image, I used architecture, which will make the kind of like the edges a bit better. If you have a lot of edges, like there is in a city, you have the edges of the buildings, you get windows and, you know, everything. You know what I mean. It will work better, as Gigapixel AI informs us. And as you see from the results, the difference is quite huge. The only downside on Gigapixel is that it took 5 minutes for it to render or export this image. And it took only 5 seconds or 6 seconds with Photoshop or the Camera Raw. And there's a big difference. But I don't think that's a decisive thing, because if you really want to upscale your image, what you need is really high quality and good quality. And if that takes 5 minutes, I think it's okay. But then I also tried the Gigapixel on the Olympus high-res file, the 80 megapixel file, to upscale it to 322 megapixels. And that took 22 minutes and 47 seconds on my computer, which is a pretty new iMac Pro. So it's not the fastest, but it's not the slowest machine either. And the same image took about 12 to 15 seconds with Photoshop or the Camera Raw super resolution feature. So Photoshop is a lot faster. Of course, 22 minutes is quite long. But if you really need a high quality print, I don't think that that's a problem, because you know it, and then you just, you know, leave it as it is and let the computer do its work and have a cup of coffee while it's doing its job. I don't think that that's a big deal. But before we test this with a portrait, there are a few things I need to say. There was some discussion about the price of Photoshop and Lightroom, and I said it's around 12 euros. Yeah, that's included taxes in different places. And many of you said that it was not cheap. But I tend to disagree with that, because subscription model is about 120, 100 and maybe 140 euros per year totally, with two softwares, and you know, you get to mobile Lightroom 2 and some cloud storage for your images too. And then the argument was that you can get with one fee, you just pay once and you can use the software. Yeah, that's true in a way. But remember, to have all the newest features, you need to renew your license, and most licenses are for 1 year. So every year you need to buy that software again, if you want to have the latest features. But of course, there's a bit of a difference in the way that when you stop paying to Adobe, then you don't then you are not allowed to use it anymore, or you cannot use it anymore. But the software that was once bought is still usable if you're okay with the older features. And to upgrade your software is needed if you get a new camera, because the RAW files from that particular new camera might not be supported with that older software. So there are upsides and downsides on both ways of paying for the software. But I think the subscription model is totally fine for me, and it's actually the best way for me. But of course, if you disagree, then you can do with a different way of paying the software, and that's really good that we have options. That's really good. And remember, it's not about the software. It's in the end of the day, it's about the image that you are making and how the image looks. Nobody cares what the software was, actually. It is all about the image anyways, and how that image looks. That's the most important thing. And then I tested both software with a portrait. The portrait was taken with the EM5 Mark II and the 45mm N1.8 lens. And there was a bit of a surprise. And the surprise is that the quality difference isn't very big, as you can see from these images side by side. And gigapixel, I use standard AI and turned on the face refinement. So it's supposed to be a bit better with the portraiture. But it seems that if you have an image with background blur, the difference isn't that big. And also, the skin looks pretty much the same. Maybe the gigapixel is a bit more natural because Photoshop's super resolution tend to over-sharpen the images, in my opinion. Or I don't like that over-sharpened look. So the gigapixel is slightly better, but of course it took that 5.5 minutes to render versus 3 seconds. So if you're in a real hurry, then that matters. But as I already said, it's not a big deal. And then the conclusion. I would say that gigapixel AI is better than Photoshop's super resolution, because in gigapixel AI you have more control and more things to adjust, and you have a bit of a different types of AI working on a different types of images. So I think that's looks to be a bit better, and the results are better, especially in architecture and cityscapes. The difference was huge, but in portraiture the difference wasn't that big, which I really don't understand why not. But all in all, if you really need to upscale your images, this is an option. Both are good options. And as I said, it's not something that I will use quite a lot. But if you have cropped images and need to make a bigger print, for example, or need more than 20 megapixels and make a huge print, then yeah, it could be an option for you. And here is the video about super resolution, and the other video is about gigapixel AI. You might want to watch those next if you haven't already done so. But hey, thanks for watching, and bye for now.